longer than expected, usually kids kind of start to fight and get restless. And so they're in the car with the dogs, and Janet had one of her favorite dogs. She did bring this dog with her, but this dog was very special. It could drink water and had like real hair and was super special. She didn't bring this dog with her, but her sister brought another dog. And you know how kids are, a lot of times when you need to share, sometimes it doesn't work out so well when you need to share. So they started to fight over the dog in the car. And mom was in the front seat and she was trying to calm them down and all that, but they just kept fighting. And you know how it is, usually one is like, "Mom, Janet's touching me," you know, in the back of the car, you know how that is. "Oh, she's hitting me. She's not sharing the dog." You know, it's just going back and forth, and then it's starting to escalate, you know. It's getting like, you know, they're starting to argue more and getting frustrated and all this kind of stuff. And so at one point, they let the window down, and the dog flies out the window. And it's like raining outside, and it's muddy, and they were like, "Oh my goodness, I don't know what happened. I hope the doll is okay." You know how us girls are about the dolls when we're growing up. So mom stops the car, she gets out the car, and she looks, and their worst nightmare comes true. The doll has fallen on the ground and is like pinned under one of the tires. And so Janet was like, "I'll never forgive you for this. That was my favorite doll." And she was just so upset. And then, of course, her sister was upset because she was mad at her. And, you know, all this kind of stuff. And they were like, "I'll never forgive you for this. It's my favorite doll. And it is ruined." And so, of course, that was a long car ride back home. Uh-huh. And when they get home, they go to their separate rooms. And, you know, Janet is in her room plotting how she's going to get back at Julie. And so she's in her room, you know, she's thinking about, okay, so yeah, she has a favorite doll with the hair that she can drink, that can drink the water and all that stuff. And she's trying to figure out how she's going to get back at her and get that doll and, like, destroy it because, you know, her sister had, you know, messed up her doll. And as she's sitting in her room, you know, thinking and plotting, then Julie comes in the room. And she brings that favorite doll that I talked to you about earlier, the one that, you know, has the very pretty hair and can drink and eat, you know, and all this kind of stuff. And Julie goes to Janet and she's like, "I'm so sorry about your doll. Mom said there's nothing that we can do to fix it, but I want you to have my favorite doll and hopefully you can forgive me." And then Janet felt so bad that she had been plotting, you know, how she could destroy that doll. And Julie comes with the offering, you know, of the favorite doll, like her prized possession, to ask for forgiveness. Yeah. And so she, of course, Janet was no longer mad at her, and she was able to forgive her. And then Janet was like, "You know what? I can't take your favorite doll, but we can share it.
That's right.
And we'll play with it together. And why don't we, you know, act like we're in school and put all our dolls together and start to play again?" Boys and girls, you should always remember that your possessions are not as important as your relationships with your family and friends.
Amen.
And also, God always forgives us, so we should forgive others.
Amen.
Amen.